a new dawn, new looter. Good morning, all about choices, hakuna huruma. Good morning, we're going global now, going global now. Oh, good morning. Rise up and shine is your time. Grind, pay a price, sacrifice, then make it. Baby, please roll me a blunt, I wanna smoke then, eh.
Good morning. Good morning, Africa, it's me from your capital, Nairobi. Good morning. Good morning, Africa, it's me from your capital, Nairobi.
You back, so fuck off and let no one salivate.
Africa's my kuja, mdogo, mdogo, bana.
Papers and liquor are all that I chase. Me, me, my freakers, galala, my wake.
Africa's my kuja, mdogo, mdogo, bana. Good morning. Africa's my kuja,
everything in this world, you could find a solution. Try Jesus. I watch know. His big grand music, you better know.
Try
Jesus. Try Jesus. Try Jesus. He's bigger than your problems. Try Jesus. Try Jesus, try Jesus. He's bigger than your problems.
First of all, let me introduce you to my King, King of Kings, the Lion of Judah, the ruler of the universe. Elevator, Vindicator, Power Terminator. His name is Jesus. Back then, before I was a freak head, I went astray. But now I'm a newcomer, brand in this kingdom. Keep it in mind, you're the productive seed.
Keep it in.
Put trust on Jesus. With men it's impossible. With God it's possible.
Now put trust on Jesus.
Try Jesus. Try Jesus. Try Jesus. He's bigger than your problems. Try Jesus. Try Jesus. Try Jesus. He's bigger than your problems.
Hey boy, listen to me. Really careful, cause letter N. I want your life to be pitiful. Sing for the world, be prayerful.
Defeat the devil, be powerful. Go down on your knees, be prayerful. Every day my Jesus is powerful. Powerful, so powerful.
Be aware, God is not more. Everywhere his sword is so strong.
Be aware, God is not more.
Be aware,
God is not more.
Put trust on Jesus. With men it's impossible. With God it's possible.
Now put trust on people.
Try Jesus. Try Jesus. Try Jesus. He's bigger than your problems.
Try Jesus. Try Jesus. Try Jesus.
He's bigger than your problems.
I know the tingle. Them call me Shadu.
Big brand news.
What a winner, man.
Sako boss.
Try Jesus.
Nitakutwanga.
Abubakar.
Jeshi wala team Hila na jamini ni na father Japo niko na watu muhim Hila mungu wangu ni wakwanza Yani kila game sipotei Baro naikamata moja namba Sila yangu yesu kila day Wanga sina visu wala panga
Fire, fire
Ye wakwanza na wamwisho Yani endo alfa na umenga
Sili taya, taya
Hata nikiangu kachini Basi ye wanga na nibe Heri alio upande wetu kushinda alio upande wao Tunavuka kila boda, we don't bother Hame tupa teti, hame tupa teo Ndiye yule ananipa mipango Ndiye yule anafanya ningare Kanifanya niwe wafiwango Milima kaifanya tambarare
Fire, fire
Ye wakwanza na wamwisho Yani endo alfa na umeda
Sili taya, taya
Hata nikiangu kachini
Basi ye waga na nibe
Fresh sound,
yeah.
Spreading gospel all over the world.
Dani amali maisha umenibariki. Tabaki kusema you my desire. Baraka umetoa, shukurani natoa. Amani baraka furaha yangu. Kati ya mbivu na mbichi nimeona uzima. Tichoki na imba we ni fire. Baraka umetoa, sadaka natoa. Umeondoa ubaya wangu. One time let me jump on your blessing. Faster refresh me, I no go regret it. All time I go enter your blessing, master befriend me, go go defend me. One time I go jump on your blessing, faster refresh me, I no go regret it. All time I go enter your blessing, master befriend me, go go defend me.
Ya fajiri, umeniamsha, mkuu baba asante, nimeamka. Sio kawaida, sio kawaida. Imeku guide mungovu zako Nguvu zako Sio kawaida Sio kawaida Imekari mkono wako Mkono wako
I don't know what to say la thank you And I like what's expressed what you have done for me Ila mina sema
Asante, 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 asante
Ila mina sema
Asante, 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 asante
Sema moto, umewasha moto, nimepata jato Nasema asante, daddy Sema noto, umetulia, zangu noto We babu melitoka msoto
Nino phase, nine come kwa isong Baba nipe nguvu niwe strong Staki kufifia niwe down Papa have me on your arms Ni low face mara nyingine Na tena na tena na tena low face Mungu baba Mimi na kuita
Umi ni bless God Siyezi yata complain Likiamka asubui niko odin Maisha rifu, maisha safi, maisha cocktail Ya upendo baraka yani I'm blessed Kutoka mashinani take me as you want yo Hadi marekani fly me to the next court Take me around the world, hadi uko Mecca. Yani uko Italia, kwa Papa Roma.
Baba na kushukuru meniokoa. Watajua jina lako kunipitia. Ukinituma baba mimi nitaenda. Nitasambaza neno lako litafika. Umeniokoa, umesimama na mimi. Nitasema umeweza sijifichi. Kwa hakika we ni mama minakiri. Umenijengea msingi thabiti.
I don't know what to say, like thank you. And I like what's expressed, what you have done for me. Ila mina sema
asante, 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 asante.
Ila mina sema
asante, 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 asante.
My father, from the start umenipigania. Hakuna kama wewe, umenisimamia kwanzia. Mina sema asante, umbali umenitoa God, asante. Sile vitu mingi umenifanyia, asante. Na sinabudi kukushukuru God, asante, yeah.
Ndiyo mimi nitaimba asante. Mino stress kwa sababu niko nawe. And I know even shida zinikute. Minita shinda so shetani ya shituke. Ndiyo mana na jidai, jidai, jidai niko ai hai. Dani ya Yesu na jidai, ndiyo mana na furai, furai, furai siko shai ai. Juvile Mungu ameniwai, ndiyo mana na jidai. Jidai, jidai niko hai hai. Ndani ya Yesu na jidai. Ndiyo mana na furai, furai, furai siko shai hai. Juvile Yesu ameni wai
hai. I don't know what to say, like thank you. And I like what's expressed, what you have done for me. Ila mina sema
asante, 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 asante.
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 Mama, it's drama. Yeah.
Ororo. Yeah, yeah.
How could I? Let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by. How could I? Treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody. How could I? Let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by. How could I? Treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody. I cover my face, ashamed of the thing that I did to you. Still I wonder if I'll ever get anybody even close to you. Maisha bila we, yeah yeah, hangover. Siwezi bila we, I can lose my money.
Sawa,
property nayo.
Sawa,
ila ni kidonda, kidonda kukukosa we. How could I? Let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by. How could I? Treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody. How could I? Such a beautiful thing like you pass me by. How could I treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody. How many times do I hear my phone, and I hope it is you calling. You say you forgive me, but it ain't enough till you come to me. Every ntombi angora hari hari has no blessing. Every ntombi angora hari hari has no blessing. Does he kiss you better, touch you better, teach you more than I used to treat you? I said, does he kiss you, touch you, teach you more than I used to treat you? How could I let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by? How could I treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody? How could I let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by? How could I treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody? How could I let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by? How could I treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody? How could I let such a beautiful thing like you pass me by? How could I treat you like a nobody, yet you made me somebody?
Nevo huku ni za juu, shingana na mimi kula huu. Wana pagawa
na huku soga za sema za bikuku Otile Brown. Dada zao, hey. Simba kwa mbuga yao, hey. Msandi kwenye game lao, hey.
Mindo kiboko yao, hey. Mume kwa dada zao, hey. Simba kwa mbuga yao, hey. Msandi kwenye game lao.
Love.
Your body so soft, you confuse my mind. Say the word, I'ma deliver on time. Anything you want is gonna be on me.
Just follow my steps, girl.
You already own my mind. What I require is fire.
Coca-Cola, you handle the killer like a Coca-Cola. I feel like an androba. Let me patrol your body like a Land Rover.
Girl, I'm watching you. Loving the way you controlling your body. Sexy attitude, talk like you walk. Walk like you talk, shake like you pose, girl. Mauna ni malizaga. Ukifunga kwenye dera mawanzo na nipatiaga. Hadi siku ya kiyama, nitakwama nawe. Nitabaki nawe, girl.
I need nobody for you. You need nobody for me. We need nobody, nobody.
Oh yeah.
sunny Mora kage it is fashion show Kakuru sitai gose offering They want everyone to know Wana shikana mashati eti nivyeo Wana begania Awa ogopi umati onatama Ime wafumania Sio mimi baba Iweke mbali na waona Kwenye vita simama Kama yangu sila nanga ona Sio mimi baba Iweke mbali na waona Kwenye vita simama Kama yangu sila nanga oh. Hallelujah oh.
Pitia na nimejifunza Moyo katili sitaki kukufania ni tena Ili mbadi na unahisia Sunajua kupenda kubaya Sitaki tena nije kufasira Atena pabaya Kidona ulo nipa nilikosa dawa Sigizi nilikosa tena kutwawe Binadamu ndo walewa Nishi nawe kwenye shida o Na kama nimekusu nisame basi pole Natamani ya nituke kichwani Sababu yote kwangu nikini
Minipone, nipone Minipone, nipone Nataka minipone, nipone Kidonda walo nipaka wale Minipone, nipone Minipone, nipone Natamani minipone, nipone Mumbibu walo nipaka wale
Hakuna alo nifuta machuzi wala kunibembeleza mi Ulinipa mapenzi kakiri uanze wewe au mimi Dunia ina mengi mazito shida na moto baridi Ila kidogo vumilia mavumilia wewe Binadamu wangu anatengeneza Ukawa sezo kamwa na kwenda Tena adhano na unaventisa
Ni umi
Na kama nimekusu nisame basi pole Natamani ya nituke kichwani Sababu yote kwangu nikini
Nipone, nipone Minipone, nipone
We hustle.
We go through.
Access granted.
We win.
We lose.
Access denied. Access denied. Access denied.
In everything, we dust ourselves.
We are the majority.
You wanna tell me just what we're dealing with here?
If you haven't guessed by now, I'll tell you who we are.
It's me. Hi.
We are the Empowered Youth.
Underground.
And this is our podcast, the EY Podcast.
Let the speakers boom.
I want to recommend very highly Coilib to every youth out there who has an idea that they want to bring on board. This is a place where you'll be incubated, so to say. You, irrespective of how rugged you feel your idea is, you come to this place and we will continuously work on you to make sure that the idea that you have is refined and at least you become the person.
Coilib Incuba. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incuba. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incuba. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
All right, of course. Welcome to the show. Know your leader. Welcome to the show, Know Your Leader. And in this show, we get to know the deal, real, and the difference between manifestos, promise,
and what was delivered.
In this phase, Android, of course, is a phase in which you strive to reach for the highest global standards of the best industry practice, even as we continue to set the best here in our studio. And only on behalf of our viewers, all questions shall be asked and all answers pursued. And today, I'm highly humbled to have three esteemed guests. From my left, we have Mr. Chemi at Linton, the Congress Maringo. We have Mr. Patrick Awino, one of the very able students in Egerton University. And again, we have Mr. Emmanuel Utieno, one of the very able students. We're going to continue with our previous talk on the welfare of the students, whether the EUSA really delivered this. On to Mr. Emmanuel. How about the welfare of the students? What do you have for us?
Okay, thank you. I thank you again for this privilege. And on the issue of welfare, we talked about it the other time. And the only thing I can add about it, we really dwell about the sports and how our EUSA leadership are not supporting our talents. And I managed to meet the Sport Congress, who told me that the main reason why EUSA haven't been supporting talents, and to be specific, EPL, that is Egerton Premier League, is because they don't have the funds to do it. And we all know that tomorrow they are going to be in the hall games that have been organized by the same office in coordination to with the different department in order to improve the talents. And I want to tell them that whatever they are organizing tomorrow is going to be successful because of the EPL. So meaning they are using what they didn't support to come in and to start a new thing. And the main point why I'm bringing this, I want to tell them, they say that they don't have funds. As a leader, if you are leading a very big institution like Egerton, you have the power to get funds whatever you want. I want to give you an example. Our leaders sometime back they walk around that they were doing, the clerk will confirm, they were doing benchmarking in different universities. And one thing they, I want them to know, that Egerton is the only public university in Nakuru County. Meaning as a president of IOSA, I have the power to go to county assembly and make my presentation there. Even if my presentation at that county assembly will be that we want you to support our talent. In our university, we have students playing football. I want you that every a semester, the county to support us with jerseys and the ball. There are so many stakeholders that can come in place to help us. And this needs a leader who is intelligent and more efficient for this possible.
Mr. Manuel, when you're saying that this team is not supporting, and here you're saying that they are organizing an event tomorrow, are you contradicting? Aren't you contradicting yourself?
No, I'm talking the event they're organizing tomorrow. I want to tell you one thing. Support. I talk about supporting the EPL. And EPL, when you look at how people, I talk about this. Yesterday, these people, they are playing every day. It means that when they are playing, they are not involved in drugs. Their coach will tell them that we have a game on Saturday and Sunday. Don't drink. They won't. They don't engage in any other thing that the youths of today are doing. Hence, this have make the university environment to be at peace. Now, today, tomorrow, the EOSA is now organizing something on mental health. And this mental health is like is something that has been ongoing. So for them, they're just coming to once and they disappear. And we want this thing to be continuous. Don't come once and disappear. Let it be continuous that we are supporting our talents, not once. That's what I was talking about.
Mr. Patrick, you know, what do you have to say about the sentiments made?
Thank you very much, Balozi. I'll not want to comment much about the EPL thing because, like in the Bible, when the disciples Jesus came to Jesus and told him that the people preaching in my name, in your name, should we rebuke them? Then they said, no, don't rebuke them. Those people who are preaching, in as long as they are preaching in my name, they, it means that they are my people also. I just want to say that EOSA as a fraternity, they have priority. And maybe they never focused on EPL as one of the priority. But then as a student, you have a mandate to do that which you feel will make your life better. So if it is organizing EPL, then you should organize it, whether you are funded or not. Does it mean that if the university doesn't chip in, then you'll not be playing? No. So definitely, you'll have to play. It is not a failure on the part of the EOSA, but it is not a priority to them. I can say that. Thank you.
This is getting interesting. Mr. Linton.
Thank you for the chance. I have a few things to say about the issue of EOSA supporting sports and not supporting sports. First, you see, before you go to that negotiation table, you have to have something that you can show, like evidence you're doing something. And I think the issue of you saying they don't really support, it goes down to every institution or anything that is short term, when you have to leave, when you have to come in, a new team to come in, it takes time. We can say that the time EOSA gets is very short. How many months, my fellow student? There are very few. There are less than, I think, 9 months or something. So you guys are elected. You are elected in maybe March there. You go for a long holiday. You come. The first semester is when you now learn, you are a toddler, you move, you know these offices. Before you know the offices, it's January. In January now, when you start now making the contacts, you are told now you have to vacate, a new team has to come in. I can give an example of Patrick, the way he's doing. Yesterday there was an activity in school. They had to engage the NRG. Before that there were some small activities, the other shows he has been hosting at Kilimo. They have really been trying, but we cannot just measure on football alone and judge the association's participation in supporting talents. We have been having the dance crews around Mau. They have even been allowed to practice there. Is in that support. Can say yes, that's some form of support. For the EPL, I think it's a huge thing, and there is EPL and there is ECL, right? There are two. So you can't say that a student's association can really support both of them. Yes, we have to find funds, but you know, they also the school team, the school teams, the volleyball team. Last week, sometime back, they were in Moi. So sports are ongoing, and we should not just base on one thing. That's an initiative for students, and students also have a role to go out there and sell what they have. EPL is gaining popularity right now because a lot of people are now engaging in it. When we were in first year, I personally never knew about EPL. So I think it's a great stride, and I can say students also have a part to bring the ECL greatness.
Yes, I've heard what the two have said. And first, Patrick have said that EUSA set their priorities, and maybe EPL was not one of the priorities. And again, the clerk, you have clearly indicated on how you are really supporting the talent. But my point is one. The reason why I came up with this topic of EPL is I want to see the magnitude that this EPL has to our boys. You say that when you present something on the table, you look at the magnitude out of all the talents that you say you are supporting. Which one will reach the student most? I think that's how we should arrange them. Which one will reach the most student most? If the reason why I really focus on this is because at some times back, they talk about the school team. They used to have the support. They used to participate in the county league. But with time, this disappeared. And you have also talked about them. You have talked about the short term in your office. But I think if I'm the president of Egerton University, when I get to that office, what I need to make a structure on how the EPL will be. So that even if I get outside that office, it's something that will be continuous. Because EPL have engaged so many students. When you go to that pitch, we have almost 12 teams in EPL. That is EPL alone. You have not gone for the other side. So a lot of students are engaged. Yes, you have said you are promoting talent, but there, a lot of talent is there. So that's why you need to focus there. Again, another thing is about now the swimming. It's still part of talent. Administration have done their best, and the swimming pool there. Everything is in place. But now, if you have been asked today that why are students not in the swimming pool, I think it's our leaders now, after administration have done everything right, the swimming pool there. In fact, there is also someone who is employed to train people swimming there. So if the students are not swimming, will we still complain about the administration, or will we complain about the student not going, or will we ask this question to our leaders, why are we not there?
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate, invest, incubate. We hustle.
We go through.
Access granted.
We win.
We lose.
Access denied. Access denied. Access denied.
In everything, we dust ourselves.
We are the majority.
You wanna tell me just what we're dealing with here?
If you haven't guessed by now, I'll tell you who we are.
It's me. Hi.
We are the Empowered Youth.
On air, underground.
And this is our podcast. The EY Podcast.
Let the speakers move. Go.
Thank you.
I want to recommend very highly Coilib to every youth out there who has an idea that they want to bring on board. This is a place where you'll be incubated, so to say. You, irrespective of how rugged you feel your idea is, you come to this place and we will continuously work on you to make sure that the idea that you have is refined and at least you become the person.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate. Invest. Incubate. We hustle.
We go through.
Access granted.
We win.
We lose.
Access denied. Access denied. Access denied.
In everything, we dust ourselves.
We are the majority.
You wanna tell me just what we're dealing with here?
If you haven't guessed by now, I'll tell you who we are.
It's me.
Hi. We are the Empowered Youth.
Underground.
And this is our podcast, the EY Podcast.
Let the speakers move. Go.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
I want to recommend very highly Coilib to every youth out there who has an idea that they want to bring on board. This is a place where you'll be incubated, so to say. You, irrespective of how rugged you feel your idea is, you come to this place and we will continuously work on you to make sure that the idea that you have is refined and at least you become the person.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
I want to recommend very highly Coilib to every youth out there who has an idea that they want to bring on board. This is a place where you'll be incubated, so to say. You, irrespective of how rugged you feel your idea is, you come to this place and we will continuously work on you to make sure that the idea that you have is refined and at least you become the person.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate. Invest. Incubate.
Technical hitch, and we're back to the Know Your Leader show. And in this show, we're here to know the difference between the manifesto, the real, the deal, after the elections, and even before. And now here we were on the point where we had Mr. Patrick defending a statement from Mr. Manuel.
Let me add something brief concerning whatever my fellow Emmanuel is advocating for. Is a fan of football, and I'll say that magnitude is a perception, and it is relative. Whatever might be magnitude to him might not be magnitude to me. For example, I might be interested in drama, things like poetry, acting, things like that. So basically, I'm among those the students who are supporting acting. I'll not basically focus on the football part. But then my concern is, you know, when we are talking about leadership, leadership is not only those who are given the position. Those who are given the position, they are just privileged, I can say that. But in all aspect, we are all leaders. I might not want to say that he's not doing his part. I feel like him, as a student who is also passionate in EPL, can also fund and can also support through donations in that activity, because they also they say that it doesn't need you to become a politician or in any other position to make a change. So I feel my friend Emmanuel has a huge task to put money in EPL, and personally I'll participate in that event if he will be in a point to do so. Yeah.
Well, gentlemen, due to time, we are going to move to the second topic, which is on the issue academics about the comrades. Previously, Mr. Manuel was on live television here, indicating and stating that the retake issue, we had very many students defer because the SGC did not disseminate information to the students on time. And he was blaming the current government, even for the group works and the rest. Maybe Mr. Emmanuel, you might highlight something on this, give some insights.
The main thing that I said was about how our current office is challenging their communication. When you compare the communication of this regime with the previous regime, is totally under the red line. Why am I saying this? Because we realize that when information is from the admin, before that information reaches the students, you will realize that some of the people who are supposed to channel it to the student are only posting on their status. And me, I believe as a student leader, when you get to an office, you know the new policies that are in office. Once you have known them, you need to come back to your people. And you tell your people that I've gotten up to this office and this is the policy that is in place, and try to emphasize them to your people. And I gave an example of what happened in the year 2021, when the portal was being closed for the first time. Those who were in the office came out and really stressed that issue to an extent. Yes, students deferred, but none complained about leaders. The reason is the school did their part and passed the information, and also leaders stressed. But when you come to this year, and the reason why I'm saying this is because the admin did their part and the information was out. But there was a point before now it was clear. There was a period where the students were so confused. They didn't know what was going on. They didn't know that they are supposed to go home. They didn't know they are supposed to be in school. No leader was talking, yet they knew they had the information. And that was my problem. Thank you.
Gentlemen, in Article 30, Section 5, Clause F, one of the roles of the Director of Academics is to enhance civic education on student-related university policy, procedures, and regulations among the members. And according to Manuel's claims, he's claiming that in this clause, there was a failure. Mr. Patrick, what do you have for us?
Balozi, I'll not assume an association of perfection. I'll not want to wish to assume that we have an association of perfection, that when we come to years, then we have a perfect association. Now, the previous regime had their also faults. I'll not also insist, also admit that they made a fault of communication. What I'm trying to say, they never boasted of some of the things they were doing, and the previous regime, they were boastful. And they used to boast. You know, when someone is boasting about something, then you'll feel, indeed, this person is really working. Now, to talk about the issue of retakes that happened. Before that thing happened, we had the receipt sessions. And by then, I was at home. In fact, most of us were at home. and we saw the memo. And personally, I called one of my friends and I told the person that the receipt is here. Do you have any? Then in a confidential way, he told me, yeah, I have it. Are you going to do it? No, I'm not going to do it because I think the university is bluffing. You get? Now, the information was passed. But now the receiver, how did he receive that information? Bluffing. But then again, the university didn't bluff. It happened. Now, concerning also retake, policies are there to be made. By the time these retake issues was introduced, by then, as much as we want to say that these leaders had information, they didn't have information at the time. Because these policies were made by the University Board of Management. Even the Senate, they never had that information. Because some of the concerns were raised to them, and they said, until now the University Board of Management, they have to see it first, then is when we'll hear out this issue. Concerning that thing, we had a class with our dean, and we asked our dean that now that we have this thing of retakes and this issue is going on, are we going home? What is our fate? What are we going to do? And remember, a dean is also part of the administration, dean faculty. She told us that visit your portal. The portal is communicating much louder than we are doing. Now, if you visit portal, you will be told you can't proceed to the next level because you have what? You have pending. You need a receipt that you've not done. So that was the information. If at all they wanted us now to, I'm not saying us because I'm now the government, but if at all they wanted the association to hire a town crier moving around the university saying, you will be deferred, this is a retake, then it is a failure on their part.
Yeah, Mr. Linton, what do you have about this being one of the EUSA?
I can say that procrastination, I don't know what why people like procrastination, but when policies are being made, they can only be procrastinated for some time. And I can say one of the major challenges this regime may be faced, that my friend here might say that they didn't advocate for the retakes, is because this retake issue was to be implemented years ago, but they were buying time, but it had to reach a point now when even the management could say that now, when are we going to buy time again for 10 years? It had to happen one time. But again, I'll support him on the issue of communication. You see, there is a way you can communicate to people, and people appreciate, and they know that this time it's legit. And there is a way you can just say an info, and then you also pretend as if you are confused, and no one will get to know if it's true or if it's not. So I think both sides, there were lapses in both sides for communication and again for the reception of the communication.
So in this docket, this is the director academics docket. So who is supposed to communicate this? Is the director academics or the SecGen?
I think there were lapses on both sides, as you see, because you can even see one of the roles of the director academics. He has to be present in the class representative assembly, something all of you can testify that it has never happened. Not that because he has never been told to do so, I don't know why it hasn't happened, because we are not supposed to beg for that. It's a role and he has to fulfill it, so there were lapses on that side. And again, on the SecGen can only communicate the overall, but to make sure to push that this thing is implemented. You see, even the quality of education, it's supposed to be benchmarked by who? The director academics. So matters academics, he was supposed to call for that assembly. And then through that assembly, maybe, you just never know, the sensitization there would have been better, and maybe the reception would have been a great one.
So you'll have to attest to me that Mr. Chemiat is bringing on board another topic of discussion, the class rep meeting, and he's attesting that it has never happened. Are we tending to say that the director academics here failed? Is it his mandate to call for this meeting?
It is his mandate to try and push for the meeting to happen, because you see, the meeting also has to have the speaker, and there's only one speaker, so I think it was it's his mandate to try and push for it.
Okay. What about Mr. Patrick?
I'll talk of something in regards to law, and it's a precedent. You know, when something has become a precedent, which means the way it used to exist, it has ceased, and now it has opted another way, and it was applied at the moment, then particularly people will use it as a law. Now, the issue of class rep assembly, it never happened. And what what has been happening is what you people have been seeing around, and whatever has been you people have been seeing around has, it is the precedent, and it is the law. So, if the DA wants to have that an assembly, maybe as one of the manifestos he might include there, then we are okay. Then we can allow that he should advocate for that assembly. But right now we are personally I don't need it. I don't need the assembly because it has taken a precedent. We are in a situation whereby we feel that the channel should flow. When information is coming, it should be going to the congresses, and from congresses to the class representatives, and from the class representatives to the comrades. We don't need any other meeting for this information to flow, because again we can give the class the information, but will they give the comrades the information? Then again we'll be advocating for comrades assembly.
But gentlemen, the chairperson herself was here, and the secretary, and confirmed that this class rep meeting happened at first. And here we are today saying that it didn't happen. So who is who? Who is saying the right truth?
I'm telling you that...
And you being the representative of the chair, you are here saying that it never happened, and the chair came here and said it happened.
I'm representative of the association I belong in, which is EUSA. Point of correction. But then let me tell you something. I've had
Mr. Patrick, the chair is also a representative of the EUSA association. So
The chair is not EUSA.
Who is
I'm representing
then?
EUSA. EUSA is an entity.
And what does the chair represent then?
EUSA chair represent EUSA, but she is not EUSA.
But you are EUSA.
I'm not EUSA. I am also a representative of EUSA.
So you're trying to say
as
you are
a member with no privilege.
Okay,
thank
it's
you.
Fine anyway.
Let me continue to whatever I was saying. I said that concerning whatever you said, that this thing has never happened. And if something has never happened, then it is not a law. For example, in Kenya, we have this law of murder when someone sentencing someone to death. Why is it that it has not been applied, yet it is still there, it has not been overruled? Because it has never been applied. In fact, the last time it was applied, I don't know it was when, but then it has never been applied. That's why the judges, they opt not to apply it. That's why I'm saying, when a culture has set a precedent, then it becomes law. Yes.
Yes, I really want to pick it from where Patrick have left it. Maybe I need to inform him of some things. That as EUSA, we are being guided by EUSA Constitution. And in that EUSA Constitution, Chapter 3, talks of organs of EUSA, which class rep is part. In that chapter, it talks of annual general meeting of EUSA, which always should take place in the second semester, called by Secretary General, announced by the Secretary General. That's how the Constitution states. I've been here for some time, and I know the reason why that meeting haven't been there. And I could have confirmed this if our chair could have been here. Before election, I told Wanini that things do happen in this office to an extent. If you don't call for this meeting as early as possible, you will never call it. Clerk, you can confirm with me. Before the class rep were paid, could you call for a meeting? It couldn't, because of how class rep were talking. And when you call for this meeting, they are majority. So the main reason why the class rep meeting haven't been there for most of the time, there is always no unity between the class rep and the SGC. That's the main reason. No one should tell you of any other thing. The main reason for the last 3 years. The last meeting we had was last year for the class representatives. And it was superheaded by the VC. That was the only meeting we had. After that, when you call for a meeting, there's always issues between the class representatives and the SGC. And that's why the SGC always fails, that if we call for this meeting, these people are going to be on our neck. And that's the reason why they don't call for those meetings. And when you talk about the channel of communication, For this academic year, we should all agree that it was bad. Why am I saying it was bad? We have leaders that they will get information, post it on their WhatsApp status first. You will hear that someone posted information on WhatsApp status 30 minutes ago. After 30 minutes when he's being posted on WhatsApp group for the classroom. And then you can't know who's forwarding the information. We used to have EUSA leadership whereby information from the DEA, from who, all information were coming down from the Secretary. And we knew that if Secretary General talks, then EUSA talks. But we are at a time that everyone wants the credit. If I have the information of the welfare, I just feel that if the Secretary passed this information, the credit goes to the Secretary. I have the information of the DA feels that if I pass this if the Secretary General passed this information, the credit will go to the Secretary General. But previously, all we knew that EUSA speaks to the Secretary General. If information from the from welfare, we just know that it's a welfare thing, but I also have spoken to this person. We saw that unity. But the moment the information is coming from any person, and in fact, the Secretary General was here. I had the Secretary General himself saying that a delegate duty. My friends, the main duty of Secretary General is to pass the information to the student. So if your main duty is to give it to other people, then I wonder, what's the main function of you as the Secretary General of this association? But my advice to whoever is going to come in the next election, if you want this, if you want EUSA to be more effective, you need to make the class rep to be on board. And the first way to make them to be on board is by involving them in this kind of meetings. And if you talk about the issue we talked about, identify the needy student, a leader cannot, a Congress, a SGC cannot identify a needy student if they don't use the class rep. And right now, even the clerk, you can confirm that some months ago, there was no close link between the SGC and the class rep.
The clerk, you can talk to that.
Maybe expound on what you mean by close links.
By saying the close link is that mostly the class reps, they were like throwing words to the SGC. And the main reason for that, they were talking that way because they were not paid. And that's created that gap between them. To an extent that they were calling for, they were class them themselves, were saying that call for a meeting, you tell us why ABCD is happening this way. But because of that gap, the SGC felt that if we call for this meeting, these people are going to be rowdy. And that's the reason why the meeting have never been there. And that's why my advice was, if someone gets an office, before any issue comes up, you call for a meeting, you clear the air, that these things are A, B, C, D, so that as you grow in leadership, you have made things clear to everyone, something that never happened.
Chemiat, you can take on.
Okay, so you, from your argument, what I'm trying to understand is that you mean when you get into office, when there is that joyous syndrome, people are still with you, now you call them, and then you disappear.
I don't mean to disappear. I want to give you an example that...
Gentlemen, let's okay. Let Mr. Patrick say something before we continue.
But I just want to correct that.
Yeah. Let's give him time. Let's give Mr. Okay. Patrick time.
Balozi, I believe of a notion that the house of quarrel is the house of peace, which means the house of silence is the house of chaos because there are a lot of plotting. I want to believe that the EUSA has been a house of peace, and that's why the class reps have been airing out their issues freely. That one to tackle is a matter of the link thing. Now, when I want to tackle the matter, I want to say that each and every individual has always been mandated by with the opportunity to lead. But what differentiates people is the aspect, the how you are leading your people. Now, some will lead people with greed, but some won't. Now, when a person leads people with greed, we have this parable of I don't know what servant, this servant that went and stole things from the boss and then gave the his friends. By the time he was sacked, then he went to those people and told them, I gave you this, return this, I should be. Then they saw him as a, in fact, it is the parable of the shrewd servant, you see? So
In that aspect, it is also the same way what we are facing in this association. Now, I can remember very well, I think it was 2020, when we were now opting for this online voting. Now, the same class representative, 20 of them were taken, despite the comrades saying that we don't need online voting. Now, 20 class reps were taken, and they were placed in a certain house, and tea was served, and then they voted.
Do you have evidence for these allegations?
Just allow me to finish.
No, you have to tell us if you have
allow evidence. I can rectify that. I'm a class rep.
Okay, just
I can rectify that, because okay,
allow me to
that call was
allow
made
me to
class
finish,
rep.
And allow me to finish, okay. Then you will say your point. I think that's the chain of communication. Now,
but Mr. Patrick, you have to ascertain your points first. You know, you can't come on live media and say that they were called without evidence.
Allow me
that,
to
that
finish.
That one we won't allow, surely. It's allow my show. We can't finish. Allow you to finish.
Allow me to
without
finish.
Evidence.
Balozi, let me tell you. When I'm saying a statement, it is my wish to start with an evidence at the beginning or at the end. I have not finished my statement. Now, 20 class reps were taken. And now 20 class reps voted for the online voting, because online voting couldn't and was not in a position to be active if at all it wasn't voted for. There are class reps who took part in that. He wasn't part of it. Maybe he was, maybe he wasn't part of that of that meeting. If you need that evidence, I'll submit it in affidavit. Thank you.
Can you kindly submit it? Kindly submit
okay,
it.
Let me correct that. I have been a class rep here, and I know for all the policies that have been made in terms of the constitution, the information was passed at around 10 that class rep should meet at Holland Hall. All class rep, remember, information was passed that all class rep to meet where? At Holland Hall, meaning this information went to all the class representatives of Egerton University. So the information that 20 class rep was called, it's going to be wrong, because information was passed to all the class representatives.
Just hold on. Mr. Chemiat, by then you are a class rep. Did you get such an information?
I got the information from my Congress by then. He told me that there was a motion to amend the constitution, so I got the info from...
Who was your Congress?
It was Mustafa Ulwichi by then.
And then were you part of that 20 team that Mr. Patrick is saying? Took tea.
From the honesty, I can say that I don't know if the number was even less than 50. They were more. They were not actually 20. They were a lot of class reps there.
So to mean they were called?
Yeah, they were called by the.
You were among them?
Yeah.
And Mr. Manuel, were you among
I
them?
Was part.
Okay.
Now, Balozi, my statement was an approximation. I failed to put that approximation. But now the truth of the matter is that they were called and they implemented this policy. But some of the comrades were complaining that we don't need online voting. It is not yet time for us to opt for online voting. There will be repercussions. But then they said it is the cheapest way of election. That's my point. They were part of that decision making. And now when things went south, some of them pulled out. They said they were never part of that session. Yeah.
I can say I was part of that session, but I objected each and everything. So that means my opinions, they were opinions of the people who I represent from where I was. So the others, if they said they voted or they didn't vote, or some who said yes, or some even abstained. So it's upon them. So the majority wins, as democracy says.
Yes. I think before he talks, yeah, I think he also supported the mind of those people who are in support of that motion. I think you are ought to say that.
But he's here, he'll talk.
The main thing I wanted to say was to correct what he said, that a group of class rep were called to a group of, you know, he have used the word a group of. But the main thing is, even if there were 60 or 10, the thing will remain that all the representatives of students at Egerton were called to be part of that. And when what happened was, it was in terms of how many are for it. Even if he was not for it, there are so many people who are not for it. But those who are for it took the day, and that's why
he personally was for it.
He can confirm. We were the people who were really struggling not for it not to be there.
But he has said he was there and you were part of it.
No, he haven't said. Patrick, the one who have given that notion, because he was not there. But we were there. We tried to say that let it not be there. But also for those who say yes for it, they have their reasons. And us who say that we are not for it, we had our reason. And that's why even today it happened, and now it's what you're going to be using. But the point that I was bringing in was about the close connection between the SGC and the classroom to identify the problem, some of the problems that the students are going through. I want to bring another question on board.
Before you proceed, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being our viewers. We'll be going for a short break. Don't go far. We'll be back.
We hustle.
We go through.
Access granted.
We win.
We lose.
Access denied. Access denied. Access denied.
In everything, we dust ourselves.
We are the majority.
You wanna tell me just what we're dealing with here?
If you haven't guessed by now, I'll tell you who we are.
It's me. Hi.
We are the Empowered Youth.
Underground.
And this is our podcast, the EEY Podcast.
Let the speakers move. Go.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money.
Coilib Incubator. Innovate, invest, incubate.
Coilib for my business has really been a point of growth because I've seen my business move from one point to another. And, you know, with Coilib, you get to understand the business aspect of it and how to make money. And
Coilib Incubator. Innovate, invest, incubate.
Welcome back, our viewers, to the show. Know Your Leader. And here, we're privileged to have our guests. We'll pick it on from where we left, Mr. Patrick. Yeah, we'll pick it on. We were here on the topic of the class reps, and we were having a difference in the discussion why the class reps haven't met the SGCs, and we were deliberating on ways and maybe the reasons why. And we are here, we have this topic that was brushed up by Mr. Manuel in the last session, and he was speaking about this issue that has really been on the headlines among the SGC members, that the class reps should be elected, re-elected per year. What is your take on this?
Now, I also have found something that we can agree with as a family. I also feel that class reps are subject for election, because again, we can't give class reps that they should be serving with no term limits. Yeah, they're the forefront people to advocate for everything. We also need fresh minds to also go and vote to advocate as class representative. I support his cause.
Yes. Mr. Manuel.
Okay, maybe you never got me right. I've been a class rep, understand how that system works for like 3-4 years now. I want to tell you one thing. Class rep, if you see that they are supposed, the main reason why this issue of class rep election came, it came last year when we were telling them, why are you not paying the class rep? That's the time this issue came up. Why did it come up? The reason was, how to identify a class rep at Egerton. Even today, even the class rep that were paid last, I'm sure 100% some were paid who are not class rep. Reason, someone deferred and he came back. When he was back, he's still a class rep. So for me, what I think you should do, you need to come with a structure. We know that we have a structure that if someone is a class rep, if a class has less than 50, he should have a one class rep. If they are more than 100, they should be two. If they are more than 150, they should be three. But because of the deferment, we have realized some class rep are deferring, coming back, and they are still class rep, and they are still working as class rep. But according to the constitution, it says that a class rep is someone who has been elected by majority of that class. So it means if you go and you defer, when you are back, you should not be a class rep. That's a definition that should be put down. And when you talk about, should we do an election of class rep now and then? To me, with the experience I had in this university, there is a link between the units you are doing from first year to the fourth year. And a lot is happening around this university that as a class rep, you need to connect your student with. So if we have a class rep, we should have one class rep who is defined by the constitution that once I'm a class rep, I'm entitled to my class. I will get to this lecturer, I will get to know this lecturer more. When I move next year, I will still have the conversation with this lecturer. If we continue changing and changing this class rep, we are going to have a problem of this communication. And the problem will also be on the payments of the class rep, because you will realize that today I'm a class rep, I haven't been paid. The next time they're going to be paid. In fact, some people will not want to be a class rep, because if they see there's no any opportunity a class rep is having. Like right now, right as we speak right now, if I ask you, any opportunity that someone will stand and say, because of a class rep, A, B, C, D has happened to me? Nothing.
So your point is that they shouldn't have.
Yeah, we should. What we need to do.
Okay, just hold on there. Mr. Chemiat, you were part of the Electoral Review Commission as a clerk.
Yeah.
I believe you are the task force that was working on this. Give us some highlights on this.
Okay, first I'll want to defer with him on one point on someone who deferred and again comes and is a class rep. I think there's no evidence to that. And the lists before payment, they are collected as directed by the congresses. Who knows? We know, for example, in a certain faculty, there are this number of courses. We know each course is supposed to produce a maximum of two. With that criteria, if they are less than 50, we have one. Those things, they are always done. There is verification, so I don't think any class they paid someone who deferred, or were you paid and you deferred? I don't think so. And I think for the issue of class reps being re-elected yearly, yes, it's a nice thing, it injects fresh blood, but again, we cannot get the whole university being disrupted by just the level of representation. So I think we should, it's upon the class. If the class feels like, no, they can easily change you and someone else picks up. So, and upon the Constitution Review Committee.
But gentlemen, I have a question here.
Okay.
We have this person X. This person is a class rep. And person X has vied for the SDC position. It is maybe a Congress. And as per Mr. Manuel's argument, is that there is a coordination from year to year. So this person X wins election. He was initially a class rep. So does it mean that this person X in office of a Congress will still serve as a class rep?
I think there we go back to the Constitution. Does the Constitution say that a Congress cannot be a class rep? My fellow members.
But okay. In the Constitution, it's stipulated for you to vie, you have to resign first.
Yeah. To resign first. Yeah. But does it say that you have to resign as a class rep and then vie for Congress?
What do you want to resign for if not as a class rep? Or you want to resign as a student?
No, procedurally, before you go for any position, you need to resign. That's the procedure. But we are in an environment where someone will resign, and then they go, they fail, they come back. But if it was an open thing, if someone fail, if you want this position, you should go back now to the election thing. That's what I think.
Mr. Patrick, your take on this?
It's true that for you to be in any position in AUSA, then you have to resign in any position you have. So you don't just resign, but in any association or position that you are in, you have to resign. Concerning the issue of class, the question you've raised,
The reason, in fact, your question is even thrilling me more because, again, it's attaining my, it's giving me more reason to support why this class rep should be, should go undergo the re-election. We are talking about bonding with these people. A leader must bond with a person. That's why even Emmanuel is complaining about the association, say, and then Chemiat, I heard Chemiat saying, now the period we have, period these people have in the office is short. It's the same thing. But now in the class rep, we are entitled them, we are giving them much, much freedom and much privilege. Because serving, because personally, I will also wish to serve as a class rep. Because I feel I also have an input. I've been in that class. You know, one thing we are forgetting, that we pick our class representative from the class that we are in, not from outside. So if the class rep had that bond and link with these people, we, the comrades, we also had this link.
But checking in the Constitution, Article 18, Section A, is saying disqualification for the SGC members. Mm-hmm. And here, the person is not qualified for nomination as an SGC if the person is an official in any other association within Egerton University. To mean this only applies to SGC members. This only applies to SGC members. The clerk, as part of the Electoral Review Commission.
Now, Balozi, allow me to comment now something different from now what I feel of the association, because the association is so pure and so so virgin as it is. But now the constitution that we are opting, it was the constitution that was it was used and it was made 2018. That constitution, trust me, has never been reviewed thoroughly and amended. And that constitution is vague, and it has a loophole, a lot of it. So whilst the incoming office, those people who wish to be in this various position, for them to make these comrades feel better, they have first to amend this constitution, because we have a lot of loopholes in that constitution. For example, that part, does it mean it only applies to the SecGen? If you go to the article which also disqualified the congresses, the congresses are disqualified, this, does it also mean that it only applies to the congresses? What about the other people? And also we have a lot of policies which are also not making sense in that constitution. So the failure of this association is constitution, and we'll have to see a way of giving these people knowledge for them to go and amend. And when you are amending constitution, be realistic. Don't amend something which helped you.
We're running out of time. Let the clerk take that.
The Constitutional Review Committee has a chairman. I think before he gives direction, there is little to no much that I can say about the whole process, because my job is just to participate, and maybe he also serves as the secretary to the commission. So I think he's best suited to answer where the steps taken and where he is at the moment. Yeah.
Well, as we wind up,
if I comment about the same, I think when secretary was here, he talked about implementing the constitution, and I think he was wrong, because he said that it was the student who forwarded some things to be amended in the constitution. As a clerk, can you confirm this?
I can't confirm, because each member of parliament came with the suggestions, so it's drafted, and again, it's supposed to be sent back to the comrades for review.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. For I also agreed on this. Our constitution need to be reviewed. There are so many inches on it, but before it gets reviewed, it's what's going to govern us. Before it gets reviewed, it's what up to now is going to guide us, and that's why we'll still insist that class type should be taken into consideration so much into USA leadership. And if I just finish by giving another gap that existed in academics, as a class rep, we do go to timetabling to be given venues for our studies, and they locate us venues. But sometimes we move to a lecture hall and realize that there are no seats there. But when you go to this room, at next to shop A, shop 1, in that room, there are some seats there.
and we have a leader of academics. Lecture hall, there's no room, there's no seat. Even when you go to student center right now, you're going to get a nice seat for a lecture hall.
Manuel, as we wind up, we have less than 2 minutes left. Realistically speaking, it's not the class rep. Just let me finish. It's not the class rep's duty to go. Just allow me talk. Mm-hmm. It's not the class rep's duty to go and maybe to the timetabling department to allocate classes. It's their duty. And I wonder, when do you have evidence for this?
Really? Listen, one of the roles of class rep is to ensure that you are taught.
To ensure you are taught, but exactly. Not to set you are.
You can also be taught in a field.
Yeah, and that, the point is that administration.
No. Just dismiss your point first. You have to dismiss the point. You can't say that class reps are the ones who go to the timetable. It's their duty.
Yes, it's their duty, but sometimes you may realize that your unit is not on the timetable. So it's you to go there and tell them that my unit is not on the timetable so that it's allocated.
But that's a correction, not setting the timetable.
Thank you for that. So my point is that we have lecture hall, very nice one, but there are no seats there. So I think that now our leaders should come together and say, I think even if you make the proposal to the school, that we have lecture hall, you realize that a lecture hall should have like 100 students, but the seats inside it is 50. I think this is a very serious issue that our leaders can now come up and say to the administration that we need chairs in these lecture halls. And again, before you do that, you also need to make correction whereby a seat is found where it's not supposed to be, yet in the lecture hall, there's no seats.
Balozi, I don't want to sound insultive, but I'll say that ignorance is a child of the fool. And the ignorance that my friend have is showing clearly that he's not understanding the aspect of leadership that I stated earlier. And I said everyone is a leader. Now, when you pass to that place and you find a chair in a place where it should not be, as a leader, take the initiative. Yeah.
Okay, so you're trying to say that now it's me now. I'm talking about...
Okay, we have our leaders here. Okay, let him give an insight on the same as we close up.
I'll highlight one of the challenges maybe in leadership is because we have the syndrome called my docket syndrome. But if we do collective responsibility, if you find a seat, don't take it out of the lecture halls, because it's not even the lecture halls alone. We have been having students carrying seats from wherever they have been placed and then taking them to the student centers and leaving them. Again, it's also the duty of the student leaders to ensure that these seats that are in our lecture halls, they are in good condition, because I'm quite sure if you go to some lecture halls, you'll find that, yes, they are metal structures. I cannot call them seats because even the writing boards are not there. So it's a win. It's a 50-50 role to be done by both sides. Both the student, let's not vandalize the seats, and for the leaders, let's ensure that we have the seats that are in good condition.
Yeah, the reason why I brought that up, the last time that we were in the class rep meeting, the VC told us that if they realize that there are some seats where they are not supposed to be, he should be informed. He told, because we complained, it was me who raised that issue at Kilimo Hall, that I'm going to a lecture hall and there are no seats. And when I go to student center, because we always know that at student center, students should come with their seats when they want to walk. To watch the ball, then it should be that there should be no any seat at student center.
But the question, as we finalize, the question is who takes the seats to student center?
I don't know.
They go by themselves to student center.
Of course they're not, and that's why if our leaders should be the one.
And as a leader, have you reported this, the issue to the VC as a leader?
No, it's a channel of communication. No, I can't go direct to the VC.
Are you a leader?
No. Yes, I'm a leader in my jurisdiction.
Are you not the one
in my
VC
jurisdiction?
Was addressing.
I'm telling. In my it told us. You know, I can't go straight to the VC, and we have a hierarchy. I can't go straight, and that's why I told you there is a gap between who class.
Have you followed? Have you followed that chain of that protocol?
According to our constitution, you know, when you have that meeting that I told you that is not existing, that's the place to air those issues. And that's why I told you, if you have those meetings, these issues, we can always air them there. But we don't have that meeting to air these issues.
Mr. Manuel, this is common sense. Sorry to say, I should be neutral, but when you find a seat there, should you report it to the admin or should
No, I know our leaders
this is the responsibility.
And are you to wait for the general meeting for you to report that you've seen a chair?
But our leaders should also be observant.
Are you not observant? Are you not a leader?
We have hierarchy. I'm talking about hierarchy here.
Okay, just to conclude, gentlemen, we have a leader here. We have a leader. You can't.
Every person has his jurisdiction. Every person has, in this leadership, every person has his or her jurisdiction.
Mr. Manuel, to cut things up, it means when you find a chair in Student Center, it's him to come and carry.
No, I need to.
But again, let me ask you a question. Yes, yes. You're a class rep. You are also a leader.
Yeah.
Or you are a student.
I'm talking about, you know, what I want you to understand is that most things that are happening in this institution, the closest person to students, the class rep.
Yeah.
That's the closest person to the student. It means, it means, if there is any suffering that students have, the person who knows is the class rep. And that's why in our constitution, it wants us to have a meeting as a family to discuss those issues. But now I've talked of one, that is, you're going to a lecture hall and there's no seats. The other time, I talk about some students suffering, but our top leaders don't have them. And that's why if we have this meeting, we can solve these issues.
We are closing the show. Just give us your final remarks.
I'll be brief. I want to say that leadership applies to everyone, whether you are given title or not given title. And I think that's why, in the first place, he's here, because we consider him as a leader because he has that information. And in leadership, there's an information that you'll wait for the meeting, and there's an information that you'll just give direct without waiting for the meeting. For example, those of the chairs in the place where they should not be, this one is a basic knowledge that when you see something which is not happening right, you'll have to take the necessary measure. You'll not have to wait for you to be called, for you to air out your issue. I'll want to say this. I'll not say that our leaders are perfect, and I'm not saying that our leaders are perfect who are in the current office. But what I'm trying to say that they have been doing the best they have been doing the best that they can. And once you are doing the best that you can, then you are a leader for me. Thank you,
Mr. Chemiat. Give your final remarks as we close.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here and to try and see the things that affect students. But as I finish, I'll like to say that majority of the problems that are affecting us, we should do it as EUSA. EUSA involves from the president to the student who has registered for that semester. And I say let us do our responsibilities together. If you are told go register for something, go do it. Do it on time. Don't wait for the last minute rush. And again, from our discussions, I have seen that most of the power lies within the students' body. Let us choose leaders who know how to articulate issues. Leaders, not just wise words, not just Bible verses or whatever. Let us choose people who let us choose people who can actually deliver. Because if you want your friend to be so and so, and then your friend doesn't perform, it's not you alone suffering. It's the whole, it's the entire university, including you. So I want to say that, and to the leaders who have been elected, let us not have my docket syndrome. Let us do there are some things you can negotiate, but there are some things you can go bang bang. You go and make sure that they are being done. Thank you.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being with us. We've had this panel, Mr. Manuel with us, Mr. Patrick, and Mr. Chemiat, who has even told us, let's not choose leaders who only know how to quote Bible verses. And let's choose wise leaders. That was our show. Thank you for being with us. Till next time, see you.
We hustle.
We go through.
Access granted.
We win.
We lose.
Access denied. Access denied. Access denied.
In everything, we dust ourselves.
We are the majority.
You wanna tell me just what we're dealing with here?
If you haven't guessed by now, I'll tell you who we are.
It's me. Hi.
We are the Empowered Youth.
On air, underground.
And this is our podcast, the EY Podcast.